Hello everyone, Treecks here, and welcome back to Kirby's Star Stacker. It will be the final part of this project. It's a one-off project, like I explained yesterday. Every single mode I will show off once. That's more than enough to call this game covered, I think. But anyway, we want to do challenge mode and time attack mode today. At least I will be trying. Yesterday we did round clear, which is literally what it says, clear all the rounds. Challenge mode is actually this game's endless. Most puzzle games always have an endless mode where you can just keep on going until you game over. And I plan on playing very hard and super hard today. This challenge mode, I think very hard is the most suiting. The time attack, I will be trying super hard. So let's go into very hard. It's not easy, but keep making those high scores. Oh man, if even the game starts saying it is not easy, then you should be scared. Okay. As you can already see probably, this goes a lot faster. The blocks no longer gradually fall down in order to give you a lot of time to try to find where you want to put things. The blocks will immediately plummet down in this mode, making it a lot harder. And I talked about yesterday's episode briefly on this subject as well, but as you can see, there's a new type of block here. The metal blocks. Which work the same as the bomb and star blocks. You can just stack them in between animal bodies and they will clear off. But unlike the bombs, which clear off entire rows, and the stars, which are actually counting towards your score, the metal blocks actually don't do anything. They're just there to be in the way, to help your stack increase, to help you game over quicker. Just don't forget, that is what the game wants. What you want is to clear off these stars in order to rack up your score, but what the game wants is that the player game overs. And these metal blocks are basically the way for the game to do that, actually. Giving you more stuff on your screen and therefore filling up the stack a little bit more. But they can of course also be used as an asset to your high scores, because those blocks can also be cleared and therefore also be used in order to rack up chains and rack up combos. Like you see over here. Bam! Ooh, nice combo. It's a rare occasion for me. Okay, already feeling great about this round so far. Normally very hard is usually the mode where I start breaking. I have been able to clear very hard on some instances, not on this endless mode though. Because I am pretty sure in order to officially clear off the endless mode on all difficulties, I'm not too sure about normal and hard actually, but I'm pretty sure on very hard and super hard and even insane difficulty, the required score you need to get in order to get the star, for the game to say you have cleared, I believe it's 1000. It's pretty high up. I'm pretty sure I'm not going to make that. Super hard, I'm usually down in minute or two, three. Usually I'm not able to survive for that long. On very hard, I usually am able to stay in the game pretty decently. Eventually, even this will get me. Trust me. And it's not necessarily a bad thing, because I don't want this to go on for forever, so it's a good thing if the game eventually manages to kill me. Basically the same way Yoshi also worked, the puzzle game Yoshi, I mean. One of the first puzzle games I covered on this channel. Whenever I did the endless mode there, basically the same thing happened. I tried to cover it for one episode and I did not even have to kill myself, because I thought, okay, now it's taking too long. No, eventually the game killed himself. And I'm pretty sure it's going to happen here too, because it usually does. I know I don't play this game all that much, but every once in a while I still pick this game up, of course, and start doing a couple of rounds of this again. And if I remember correctly, usually around 10-15 minutes is usually how long I'm able to stay in the game on very hard. Even though I'm not able to see what my high score is right now, because I'm not playing this on my actual Game Boy. I'm playing this on the Super Game Boy. Emulated, of course. Because of me being... needing to... be able to attach my capture card to the game, of course. Because otherwise it won't record. And I don't know if you have noticed, but Game Boys... and Super Game Boys, or Game Boy Players, or whatever you try to play it on... they don't actually have an HDMI input, so I kind of have to do it like this. But it is still my cartridge of Kirby's Superstar I'm doing this on, so you don't have to worry about that. But because of that, I don't have my high scores present. Those are not saved on the ROM of the cartridge. Don't know why, because it should be, but apparently it's not the case. So therefore, I'm not really sure what my usual scores are, what I usually get on this. But I'm pretty sure it's around 300 points. Even though I don't think I'm going to make it this time, because I'm pretty high up on my stack already. Let's see if I can clear something off. And remember, in order to fail, in order to game over in this game, only the middle columns, the center columns, are the only ones that matter. So you can let the stacks rise up as high as you want on the edges. The two left and two right columns don't. Those two don't matter. The center columns are what determines when you game over. So it's usually not necessarily a bad thing if the two edges of the screen get filled up. It does give you less room to place your blocks in, making it harder to actually stay alive. But the plus side is that whenever things get crowded on the edges, things like this could happen. If things start falling apart from the middle on, the edges can help you get combos easier because of there being more animal friends there. So those blocks have a higher chance of becoming a combo the moment you are able to clean up the middle. I'm pretty sure that is usually a strategy that people use in these kinds of puzzle games, this one not excluded. Just try to get your stack as high as possible, because of the more blocks you have, the higher chance of you being able to chain combos together, and therefore increasing your high score pretty quickly. Because the best way to deal with these games is not to go for stars one by one. If you do it like that, then every single move you get only 1 point. If you try to combo things, you actually get multiple points. Especially if the chain reactions start happening and Kirby starts charging his stars. Like here, chain reaction, two. You always get an extra pair of stars, even if you get only one. Of course, you're going to want to have as many as possible. The more chains you have, the more stars Kirby will throw for extra points. So your score gets higher quicker. It's basically the strategy you're trying to go for. Okay, thank you. Yeah, if it isn't obvious, I'm kind of remembering that I never really talked about that. But of course, every block you get, you can always just turn around. You can turn them clockwise if you press A, or counterclockwise if you press B. You are of course not forced to place the blocks in the way the game hands them out. Oh, thank you. Bam. Bam. Nice combo. I got pretty lucky there because I was getting into some trouble once again. But thank you, game. Because that was not my doing, I'm going to be honest on that. Whenever things like that happen, it's always luck. I'm not the biggest star in this game, like I explained earlier. It is these blocks that fall in certain locations randomly that sometimes get me out of the fire, because usually I'm not able to do more in this game than just try to directly go for these star stacks. Just see, oh, there's two animal friends of the same kind, so I'm going to link them together and then hope for the best. I'm usually not that kind of a guy who's able to plan my moves ahead in this game. Therefore seeing, oh, I need to place this block here. So that block will fall over there, and those will clear out. And yeah, I'm not the kind of guy who usually does that, so... if it on occasion does happen, then it is just luck, trust me. I must say, I'm surprised I'm able to get this going for so long, even though I'm distracted a lot. I've been saying way too many things. Because of that, I should be bad at this. Because I'm definitely not really paying attention to the game, and yet I'm still in it. Okay, if the... Ah, dang it. Oh. It was not what I was going for, but it also worked. If the situation might occur that I think, oh, this is going to take too long, because I also want to show off the time attack mode in this episode. I don't want to make a 3-episode project out of this. If I think this is going to take too long, then I will just game over myself. And I think I will do that at the 15 minutes. If I'm still going after 15 minutes, then I will just end it myself and call it a day. So I can show off time attack mode on the super hard difficulty. Definitely looking forward to that. I'd really like to get rid of that bomb, but I need a coup for that. Oh, or a Rick apparently. I did not see that move, but it also works. Like I said, if fancy moves start happening, it is just luck. Trust me, I don't know what I'm doing here. I'm just doing something. And sometimes I accidentally survive because of that. Okay, I'm getting close to 300 points. Might be a fine little landmark to reach. Bam. Two more. So, is there anything else I need to address? Well, I'm trying to survive here. I could also talk about that other Kirby puzzle game that is still up for grasp. Even though I don't own that game, but there's of course still Kirby's Avalanche, SNES Kirby puzzle game, that's also a thing. For some reason, that's the only one I never really got for some reason. And in all honesty, I don't know why not, because back in the day I was still a little bit into puzzle games, and I was still in Kirby. That's something that did not go over. Puzzle games, for some reason, at some point stopped for me. I did still enjoy the ones I already owned, like this one, but for some reason I never really had the motivation to get myself new ones, and that's basically the reason why after the 90s it kind of stopped for me with puzzle games, because they of course still came out after that time, a little bit less frequent, but they were still there. But Kirby's Avalanche, the SNES Kirby puzzle game, it definitely was from the time that I should have just bought it, in all honesty. Me still being into puzzle games and me already being into Kirby. For some reason, I never really got into that game. I might do that in the future if I'm able to get my hands on it for some reason. I'm pretty sure it's not on any of the virtual consoles or on Nintendo Switch Online SNES. So I'm not able to play it there. That is also still a puzzle game, but don't wait on that one to show up, because, like I said, that is a game I don't own. So Kirby's Avalanche is not happening, therefore this is the only Kirby puzzle game I have. Of all the Kirby spin-off games that are going to come by in my Let's Plays, this is going to be the only one. That's basically what I'm trying to say here. Okay, thank you. Bam. Getting close to being in trouble again, so not a bad thing. 40 minutes, okay. I'm getting close to... Uh-oh. Thank you. It's already going pretty quickly, and being so close to the top of the screen, I can't see the blocks coming, so I don't really have time to use them properly. Yeah, then usually a game over is imminent. Okay, nice little timestamp to do that. And for this one you also get a winner screen if you're able to get a score high enough. Yeah, it's not good enough to get to the star. Like I said, I'm pretty sure it's 1,000 points you need to reach on these difficulties. That I clearly did not do, but that's basically the challenge mode. Just an endless mode where you keep on going until you game over. Okay, let's see how time attack works. So, just how many stars can you stack in only 3 minutes? Of course, it does what it says. Time attack is you get 3 minutes and just see how far you can get in those 3 minutes. And of course, it is about your star count. Okay, let's see if super hard is going to kill me. Of course, even faster than very hard was, even more metal blocks, making it even tougher to get your stars out of the way. And when it comes to clearing time attack, I believe the limit you need is 100 points. If you're able to score 100 points, then you clear. And in the case of super hard, of course, like in all of the other modes, you also unlock insane if you do that. So. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Bam. 17 points. And here on super hard, it is even a miracle if I manage to survive for those 3 minutes, or let alone get 100 points. But I will try. I'll see how far I can get. And we can call this a project. Not just an episode, but a project immediately. All of the modes will have been shown off at least once. It's good enough for me. Doing all this on insane difficulty, where you actually have to do 50 rounds of round clear and endless, getting 1,000 points. Something I was not able to do in very hard even, so let alone insane. Yeah, that's not happening. So doing it like this is fine enough. It's not one of the most amazing games ever made, so just doing a quick little cover of all of the modes once is more than enough to cover this project. Okay, I'm still alive. We're more than halfway done. When it comes to the time. Combo, hell yeah. Bam. Oh, another one. And another one. Game loves me today. Bam. That's a combo. Might be even able to reach that 100 points if I keep on going like this. I don't think I've ever been able to do that, actually. And maybe once. I've been able to do it on very hard once, I remember. Super hard? That would be a first. I'm getting really lucky with these combos right now. Because trust me, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just getting lucky. I'm just trying to find places where I can stack these animal friends together, and nothing more than that. All the combos that happen after that are just pure coincidence. Okay, that won't give me anything. Okay, here's another combo, and another one. Okay, 92. 96. Getting close. Okay, time's up. Didn't make it. Oh wait, I did make it! The final one still counted! Hell yeah! Well, 100 points. I'm pretty sure this is actually... Yeah, you can see it already. The star is given to me. A record of 100 and beside it the star. So you know you've cleared it. And yeah, it is 100 points. If you clear 100 points of super hard, you actually unlock insane. Told you that was a thing. Well, still have some time, it's not even 90 minutes yet, I'm just going to try it. Maybe I will finish this game 100% if I'm able to do this. Whoa, that goes really fast. I don't even have time to see what kind of a block it is. It just immediately appears. Oh god, I'm already dead. Okay, I'm still alive. Man, even the clearing off of these blocks goes really fast, as you can see. Even here I get really lucky. Man, this got really fast. Normally I call myself a speedrunner. Normally I say I really like when games go fast, but in puzzles, that's not necessarily the case. This goes a little bit too fast for me. Come on, cool. Yeah, this is where it ends already. 50 seconds I managed to live. Okay, I'm instantly in a mellow mood. If you like to have a laugh, go play this game on Insane, if you manage to even unlock it. Okay, that is it. No 100% clearing this game. Insane is too hard for me. But if you, as you can see, there's also this record screen where you can see how many points you have gotten in the challenge and time attack modes. That's basically the only other option you have in this game. The versus mode I will not be able to show off because... yeah, on the Game Boy you need a link cable and everything, and that's not really a thing. And I don't even have a second player, I don't know anyone who also owns this game, so... not an option. And with that, I can say this game has been fully covered from round clear, challenge attack, and time attack. Okay, quick little project this was. It was a little bit of a mess showing this off, but... the game has been showed off. I can call this a let's play. Kirby Star Stacker. Try it out if you would like. If you do think you're able to do these kinds of things, then go right ahead. Even though I'm not too sure how you how you're able to get your hands on this game nowadays, but it should, in theory, be possible. Maybe in the future when the Game Boy games get a little bit better distributed over the modern gaming systems. I'm not too sure if that will ever happen on the Switch, but it might, it might. It was a quick little one-off project, but still, there's a next Kirby game coming up, of course. And that is going to be Kirby Superstar in the future. Not starting right after this one, of course, but eventually you will find me uploading Kirby Superstar. It's going to be the next Kirby game I am going to cover. Because Kirby's Avalanche, I do not own. But anyway, hope you still enjoyed this quick little one-off project. And I will see you next time. Treecks out. Later, folks.